Okay, in this lesson, we are going to look at optimization of cost. So we want to optimize the cost where we are using the least amount of money available. So most of the steps are the same as in the previous section, but just remember in each question, the quantity to be optimized is the total cost. So you may have different prices for different materials. So if you walked around some neighborhoods, you might notice that houses have different kinds of brick on the front than they do on the side. And that's pretty common because the bricks on the front of the house usually cost more because they're more pleasing to the eye. They have more driveway appeal, whereas the bricks on the side cost less because you don't see them as much and they're just a smaller, cheaper material. So that happens quite often in construction, is where they'll use different materials for different parts. So in question six, this is right from the guide, we have a rectangular rose garden that's going to be surrounded on three sides by a brick wall and a fence on the fourth side. And the area has to be 1,000 meters squared. The brick costs $192 per meter, whereas the fence only costs $48 per meter. So we want to find the dimensions that will cost us the least amount. So what do we know? Let's draw a diagram. So I have a rectangular rose garden. So that means there'll be two widths and two lengths. I also note that the area has to be 1,000 meters squared. And area is length times width. So that's one of the parameters of the question. So I'm going to write out a cost equation here. So I know that three sides are going to be brick, and I know one side is going to be a fence. So the three sides that are the brick are two widths and a length. So I'll just color those in here. So this side, and this side are going to be brick, and then this side is going to be a fence. It doesn't really matter which three, but we'll just pick three. It's not going to make a difference in the question. And then one side is going to be a fence. So now we're going to put in the cost for each. It's going to move this over a bit. So we'll put a length here. So now we're going to put the cost of each. So the brick costs $192 per meter, whereas the fence costs $48 per meter. So this is my cost equation. So I have three walls that are $192 per meter, and I have one wall that's going to be $48 per meter. So let's just expand this. So we have 384 width plus 192L plus 48L. And so that would be 192 plus 48 is 240. So that's my cost equation. Now, I want to maximize cost. And I also know that the area, remember the area has to be 1,000 meters. So that has to be considered in this question. So I have a cost equation that has two variables, W and L, and I only want one variable. I also know the area has to be 1,000. So I'm going to isolate for L, and then I'm going to sub this into my cost equation for L so that I have an equation with only one variable. Okay, so let's simplify that. So 240 times 1,000 is 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. And I'm just going to move the W to the numerator. So there's my cost equation. I want to maximize cost, or sorry, minimize. So let's find the derivative. And then we want to find the critical point. So we're going to set that equal to 0. And then we want to solve for W. So I'll bring this to the other side. W squared equals 384. So W will be the 2400,000 divided by the 384, and then we're going to square root that because it was W squared. And so this will give us our dimension for width, which works out to be 25 meters. Then I can go back and find length. I know length is 1,000 divided by the width, so the length is going to be 40 meters. And so in order to minimize cost, the width of the rectangular area is going to be 25 meters and the length is going to be 40 meters. Okay, looking at the next example, so let's look at question 7. So in question 7 we have an indoor swimming pool. It has a rectangular floor area of 4800 meters squared. So we know 4800 meters is the area. So we have a rectangular floor area. So we've got length and width here. Three walls of the pool will be glass and one will be brick. So three walls, it doesn't really matter which three. Three walls will be glass and one's going to be brick. The cost per meter of the glass is 2 times the cost of the brick. Find the dimensions of the floor area that will minimize the cost of the building the wall. So again, the cost, we're going to have three walls that are glass. And one that is brick. So the cost is going to be three walls that are glass. The glass is going to be twice as expensive as the brick. So three walls of the glass would be two widths and a length, and it's going to be twice as expensive as the brick wall, which is one length. So I have one length that is brick, I have two widths and a length that is glass, and the glass is going to be twice as much as the brick, so I'm just going to put a 2. So in this question we don't know the actual cost, but we know it's going to be double for a glass and a brick. We also know that the area has to be 4800 meters, so we're going to substitute in to replace one of these variables so that we have an equation with one variable. So I'm going to just do L again. So it'll be 4800 divided by W, and I'm going to sub that in for the L. So let's clean this up a little bit. So we've got 4W plus 2L plus L. So we've got 4 widths and 3 lengths. And then we're going to replace 4800 over W for the L. And then we'll expand that. So 3 times 4800 is 14400. We'll bring the W to the top so that we can apply our power rule. So we want to minimize costs, so we want to find the derivative. So that would be 4 minus, and then subtract 1 from the power, and then we just solve. So we're going to set this to 0 to find the critical point. And then we're going to solve. Equals 4, and so W will be 14400 divided by 4, and then we're going to square root that. And that works out to be 60, and then we can find the length by taking the 4800 divided by the 60, and that gives us 80. So the dimensions will be 60 by 80, and that will minimize the cost. In this question, question 13, we want to create a box. So the box has a square base and no top. So the base would be x by x because it's a square, and the height will be y or h, whatever you want to call it, and it's not going to have a top. So we don't need a top on this box. And we also want the volume to be 500 centimeters. That should be a cubed. What should be the dimensions of the box to minimize the amount of material? So you don't have to actually have a specific cost. We just want to find the dimensions that will give us the least amount of material. So we do know that volume is length times width times height. That has to be 500. And in this case, the length and the width are both x. So we'll say x squared times h. We also know that we want to minimize surface area. So the surface area would be the bottom, there is no top, plus the four sides. The dimensions of the bottom is x squared. The dimensions of the side are x times y. I should put a y. Well, let's use an h. Let's be consistent here. So we'll call it h. Because I did my volume in h, so we'll just be consistent with h. Okay, so 4x times h. We have four sides that are x times h, so 4xh. Now, we want to solve this for the minimum amount of area for x, but we have this h as well. So we're going to take our volume, and I'm going to isolate for h, and that's easier than isolating for x. I could isolate for x, but if I isolate for x, then I've got a square root, and it just makes it a little more complicated. So if I have this single variable of h, I'll just isolate for h. And so I'm going to substitute this in for the h. And then we'll just simplify this equation here. So we have x squared, 4 times 500 is 2,000. X is reduced, so b over x, so x to the negative 1. And I want to minimize the surface area, so we'll find the derivative. So 2x minus 2,000, x to the negative 2. We want to solve for x, so let's set it equal to 0 so we can find that critical value. So bring the 2,000 to the left. That's a negative 2. So it's 2,000 over x squared equals 2x. So I'm going to cross multiply. So that's 2x cubed. And then I'm going to isolate for x. So we'll divide both sides by 2. And we want x, so we're going to cube root. So we're going to cube root 1,000 to find x. So x will be 10. Does it say the measurements? It's in centimeters. So x is 10 centimeters, and then I can find the height by dividing 500 by 10 squared, which makes it 5 centimeters. So the dimensions to minimize the amount of material needed to make this box would be 10 by 10 by 5. Okay, question 14. Again, we're doing a box. The volume has to be 15 meters cubed. And it has a square base and top, so we'll call it x by x, and we've got a height. It does have a top, so the last question there was no top, but this one has a top. And the volume, which will be the base times the height, has to be 15 meters cubed. The materials would be the surface area. So we've got a top, a bottom, and four sides. So the top is x squared, the bottom is x squared, and then the four sides are xh. Now, they all have different costs. So let's do our cost equation. So the top of the box is $2.50. The bottom of the box is $7.50. And the sides of the box are $4.50. Okay, so we have $2.50 x squared plus $7.50 x squared. We'll just add those together, so that's 10. So we've got 10x squared. Then we've got 450 times 4, So that's 18xh. Now, we have to have one variable. So let's take our volume. And I'm going to isolate for h because it is a single variable rather than a square. So I'm not going to have that square root in there. And I'm going to replace h with that. So we've got 10x squared plus 18x. We're going to replace the h with 15 over x squared. And then we'll simplify that. So 18 times 15 is 270. X is reduced, so divided by x, or x to the negative 1. Now we want to minimize the cost, so we'll find c prime. And then we're going to solve for x. We'll replace c prime with 0. Let's bring the 270 to this side. So I'll put the x squared on the bottom. Then I'm going to cross multiply and divide. So 270 over 20 would equal x cubed. And so we'll just take the cube root of 270 over 20 to find x. And that works out to be 2.38 centimeters, or maybe it's meters. 2.38, let's see, it is in meters. And then the height we know is going to be 15 divided by 2.38 squared. So the height's going to be 2.65. So the dimensions will be the base, so that's 2.38 times 2.38 times the height, which is 2.65.